score over here. So if you open the book scores before the examination, unless you are adding tension, be in a relaxed mood, whatever that you have read before that particular day, you just memorize and write with a lot of confidence. Attempt those sections on which you have got 100% confidence. Those questions you are very confident, attempt those and then take relatively difficult and keep most difficult to the last. That's why you are able to crack the examination with much more ease and confidence, and definitely you are all going to get good marks. I'm sure of it. By the way, you all know for how many marks the exam is?
720.
So write well. And just to give you an overall view of the MBBS scenario. By the way, I'm Srinivas. I'm here from the Avalon University School of Medicine US. We are having, how many colleges are there in the country which are offering MBBS? Any guess? There are 476 medical colleges in the country. The total seats are 61,140. In the state of Gujarat, there are 24 medical colleges with an overall seating capacity of 3,840 in MBBS. To enter into the MBBS course, you have to pass NEET examination. For 2018 NEET examination, 13,66,000 students have registered across the country. In 2017, 11,25,000 students were registered. Out of this, 6,11,000 students qualified. And see the increase in the number for 2018. Almost 2 lakhs has gone. Not every student who qualifies in the NEET is likely to get a seat. Students should be the top percentile in order to get a seat in now. We have seen 61,140. Out of these seats, 50% of the seats are in the government medical colleges. 50% of the seats are in the private medical colleges. And in private medical colleges, if a student has to secure a seat, then they have to pay a lot of donations. This is a huge yearly tuition fees. The present state of private medical education in the country is a minimum of 60 lakhs to more than a crore of rupees is expected for the private medical colleges as a donation from a student just to give a seat in MBBS. But
could be any sort of that so you can just ask us to stop and you can go to the patient.
If you do not understand English, you just tell me so that my colleague can explain to you in Gujarat. Please do not hesitate to ask.
I mean, nothing from that, slightly change it to stop for a moment and you know, and then do nothing more for
it. Is that okay? Fine. So, as I told you, getting an MBBS, you have to pass in the NEET. Now, the scenario is, MBBS is just only a degree. But what is the future for MBBS? Student who pass this only MBBS can end up as a duty medical officer in one of the few private hospitals whose salary will not be more than 35 to 40,000 rupees. After spending 5.5 years, after spending few lakhs of rupees as a donation in a private medical college, this is the future for a medical school for an MBBS student. Say yes or no. So what is the yes for that? What is the future for the doctor? He has to study. This is the PG. Unless a student completes PG, there is no future for MBBS. But how to enter into the PG? For entering into the PG again, the student should qualify in the NEET PG. Those who read the newspaper, I am sure you are aware of this also. You are aware? Now, I have told you, in MBBS we are having 61,146. Whereas in the PG, we are having only 6,506. 10% of this. Whereas the number of students who appear for MBBS are those who are registered this year is 36,66,000, and 2017, 11,55,000. And for the PG, 2017, 1,29,585 students are registered. For the NEET PG, only for 6,500 students. So you have a lot of competition at the MBBS, even at PG. In other words, only one student out of 10 or 15 students has a chance to do either MBBS or the PG. If this being the case, you are spending 2 full years in your HSE preparing them for your NEET examination. Each one of you are having right merit. But sometimes what happens is, even a mark makes a lot of difference in the ranks because of the competition. If this being the situation, we consider this totally as plan A. We call this as plan A. You are MBBS in India with this many number of seats. Suppose if the plan A doesn't happen, then what is the alternative? Can anyone tell me? If student does not get a seat in MBBS, what is the next alternative? Biotechnology. How many colleges are offering biotechnology? And what is the future for the biotechnology again? Unless a student completes a PhD in biotechnology, the field is not proven. In biotechnology again, there are industrial biotechnology and food biotechnology, so on and so on, several some areas are there. In each of these areas, if you are planning for a very good career, you should complete PhD after doing a PG in that particular biotechnology. But again, limited number of colleges, limited number of seats. Okay, that is one option. What is other options? So we have to apply our mind to think what are the options here. Suppose if I tell you an excellent option which is as good as MBBS or nothing but an MBBS but not in India but outside India. Would you be interested to know? If you are interested, then we can go for that. Should we? I would consider this education, MBBS outside India as plan B. What is that education outside India? There is a medical university called Avalon.